There you go.
Thank you.
You probably don't spend a lot of time thinking about how the buildings we are in are made of. But my grandmother does. I call her Memegit. She's 80 years old, a woman, not the most imposing person. But she's also a farmer, she's still a farmer. And I would not say she had an easy life. She's living in a beautiful house, very traditional in the region of Bresse in France, with these red bricks. This is also very cold in winter. Actually, I realized that when I spontaneously visited her, and I realized that she's only heating up when one of her grandchildren comes and visits her. For her, resources have to be treated with care. Actually, I learned from her how to treat objects with respect and think how to repair them, to reuse them. She often says, someone's waste is another person's treasure. So when we wanted to change the roof of her house, we actually reused tiles and bricks from an abandoned house of her old aunt. At that time, we also wanted to put insulation in her roof. The goal for the insulation was to provide her comfort and also allow her to save energy and cost when she wants to heat it up during the winter. I remember when we were looking for the insulation material, my uncle and I, we wanted to have a material that is easy to install, safe, non-toxic. For my grandmother, it has to be cheap and also fire resistant. Actually, when she was 12 years old, there was a fire in her house, and she was very anxious that this could happen again. At the end, we realized it's not so easy to find a product that fits all requirements. That's why we ended up using glass wool. So glass wool, first of all, is not a fully fire-resistant material. And then it's not as cheap as my grandmother would have liked. Also, you have some fibers inside, and that makes your skin quite itchy even days after. But you also have a glue inside this material, a plastic, a resin glue that holds these fibers together. And this makes this product difficult to recycle. I remember for my grandmother, it was difficult to realize that this material could only be used once. Alternatives to that would have been to use stone wools, plastics, but these products are either flammable, toxic, or not very ecological. So at that time, it was difficult to understand that you could not find a widely available solution, but we had to deal with it. I realized actually during my studies that the problem is much bigger than it seemed. In fact, 40% of the world energy consumption and 1/3 of the greenhouse gases emissions come from buildings. This is huge. And this is mainly due by heating and cooling our buildings. So here, insulation is actually one of the strongest factors to reduce these numbers. There is a study saying that we could reduce by 70% the building's energy consumption if we were sufficiently insulating our buildings. So when you realize that we are building the equivalent of one New York every month, you quickly realize also that we will need a lot of insulation materials. But with insulation materials, you have a problem. Actually, these materials are not, will take a lot of energy to be produced, but they will also be very difficult to recycle. That's why, for example, in Switzerland, 1.5% of insulation materials are recycled. 1.5%. This is nothing. There is actually one big reason for this. The materials that take a lot of energy to be produced, they also are very difficult to separate inside a building because you will have some glues, you will have some contaminants, and you have different families of materials. And this is very difficult at reasonable cost to recycle them. Actually, these materials will be usually thrown into a waste recycling plant to produce electricity, or worse, they will be landed in the landfill. That's why today 35% of the world's landfills are made up of construction waste. So this is critical. As humans, we have the tendency to solve first our short-term issues, procrastinating the long-term ones. Here we face a paradox, with a long-term issue becoming short-term. So now this is the moment to think how we can recycle these materials and to build them in a way which does not destroy our bigger home, our planet. So how can we design a material, an insulation materials, that is safe, that is non-toxic, while minimizing the environmental footprint? This is what my team and I have been working for the last 5 years. We wanted to create an insulation materials that is meant to last, but also to be torn on in a way which does not harm anyone or damage anything. For this, we wanted to use local materials that are widely available. So we use two of the most abundant materials we have on the planet: rocks and air. We don't need specific rocks. We actually use the rocks that results from digging a hole on the construction site when you want to build a house. So not the most valuable materials at a first glance. We take the finest part of these stones and we create foams with a lot of air inside. So imagine, we basically bake the stones with some water, like a cheese souffle. And at the end, we can have a foam with 99% of air inside. In the 1% way, in the 1% left, we have our treasure, the waste, and some minerals that we developed. At the end, we have insulation panels. They will insulate very similarly to standard material, thanks to the air that is entrapped inside. They will also be fully fire resistant. We are dealing with a stone here. And you can imagine they will be quite cheap. But what is very interesting here is that you will need a very low, they need a very low energy, and they will result in a low carbon footprint during their production, because you use local materials, because you have low energy processes involved, and also at the end of life. You can take the foam, you can crush it, and you can make a new foam again. Cherry on the cake, you can also recycle this material along with the other materials in the facade of your building, for example, with the concrete, with the bricks, because all these materials come from the same family. They are all stones. You don't need these plastic glues anymore. This process can be transposed to different types of waste, depending on the region where you are. For example, you can work with ashes from different industries. You can work with concrete waste, tile waste. This gives this different color to the foam. So this is an opportunity to rethink construction by putting attention on what can be used locally and how to treat a building at the end of life. With this approach, we have the opportunity to work locally with local materials. This will help businesses against shortage of resources and unstable price, and it will also allow to minimize the transport of the material. With this approach, the recycling rate of insulation materials could ramp up from 1.5% to 40% in the next 30 years, being realistic. So we wanted to find a solution for my Mimi, for my grandmother, that is safe, cheap, performing, and sustainable. Today, a solution exists. It is our duty to make it widely available for the future generations and to provide them the comfort that I wish my Mimi had. Thank you.